Recently, I was really curious about how the function tool within the OpenAI block in TypeBot worked. So I headed over to the documentation and I noticed that there's this example provided on how to use the function tool in that OpenAI block. And then also, while reading the docs, I noticed that there's this line here. A more useful example would be, of course, to call an API to get the weather of the city the user is asking about. So if you notice down here in this example, there's a simple if condition or if statement, pretty much returning sunny and warm if the user types in Paris, and then rainy and cold if it's anything else. So I took a stab at this to try to get an actual API to work, and I'd like to share those results with you. So if we head back to TypeBot, we can go ahead and try out this quick demo. So I'm prompted with enter city to get weather report. So I'll type in San Diego. And now the ChatGPT or the OpenAI block uses that function call to make that API call to a weather service called OpenWeatherMap and then pulls back what you see here. So it says the current weather in San Diego is broken clouds with a temperature of 64.78 degrees Fahrenheit. If you worked with making API calls, you've probably done something like this, where you do some sort of like HTTP request and then pass in a user's parameter into the API call to then retrieve data. If you found this video helpful so far, please consider subscribing to the channel, giving this video a like, leaving a comment down below, or sharing with a friend. It'll really help me create more videos for you guys. So, as a quick overview, this is traditionally what you would have to do to make an API call to a different service. You'd put in the API base URL, you'll put the method of the call, you'll put in your headers, the body, and so forth. And then you'll probably pass in some sort of like user-provided input, like their name, their email, or some sort of value, right? So this other method that I'm showing you with the function tool in the OpenAI block doesn't require any of this. So it's kind of weird, well, at least it was for me, to let OpenAI just take care of that for me. So what we're gonna do next is I'll show you how that looks like in the OpenAI block. Okay, going over to the OpenAI block, let's go ahead and expand this. Something that I noticed was you really only need one input. Which is the user role. And then you pass in the user's message, which contains the city name, right? I think it might be beneficial if you also put a system prompt up here with more kind of specific information on how you want the ChatGPT to respond back to you. But I found that it wasn't necessary. So let's go ahead and just delete that for now. And then down here, you'll see that under tools, this is where the magic starts. You'll notice that you need a name, a description, and then you pass in some parameters. And then if we go down below, this is where you pass in the code. The documentation on how this works is a little light on the TypeBot docs. So I would suggest going over to OpenAI platform docs and then just kind of going through their documentation to understand how some of these different components work within the function and tools. So if we scroll up here, you can see this is the function calling. So you can learn how to connect pretty much the ChatGPT to external tools. And there's quite a few other pages of documentation to get you started and to provide a little bit more context about kind of like the different components of the function call. And here it is actually. Now that we're here, you can see that under tools, these are the different properties that you can pass in. And they're all provided or included in the TypeBot block. So here's a description, the name, and then the parameters. Heading back to TypeBot, here is the code that I used. And I'll go ahead and provide that somewhere on my website or in the description. But this is effectively what I used. And one thing to call out if you want to follow at home, I did use the OpenWeatherMap service and its version 2.5. The latest seems to be 3.0. However, I noticed that passing in the city wasn't a parameter that I could use. So it only accepted latitude and longitude. So it was a bit harder to try to pass in that user city input into this function call. So I just use a 2.5 and it works just fine. So if you go to openweathermap.org, you can easily create a free account, use or generate a new API key, and that's pretty much all you need. Something I want to call out is the description value that you have to put in. So here I put in get the weather for the provided city. So it's very clear instruction for what GPT should be doing. And if you go over to the documentation for the API reference docs, you can see that for description, it says a description of what the function does, used by the model to choose when and how to call the function. So that's really the instruction that you're giving GPT to trigger that function and for what value needs to be inserted. So if we go back to the TypeBot, you can see what sort of parameter that you want to pass in, right? So you're instructing it that it's a city, and then you also want to be descriptive of what it is, right? So this one's kind of a simple example. We're just calling it the name of the city, but you also want to be descriptive, right? If you're doing some sort of other function call. And that's it for this video. I'm really excited to continue exploring how to use these function calls and also kind of figure out where the limitations are, because we're essentially just giving ChatGPT full range to make those API calls for us. So if you have any questions, comments, I'd love to hear it, and I'll see you in the next video.